Nang dumating ako sa Korea ay nakita ko ang larawan ng bulaklak na yuche sa Jeju-do, kaya talagang gusto ko makapunta doon. 한국에 오고 나서 제주도의 유채꽃 사진을 본 적이 있어요. 꼭 가보고 싶었어요.
Now, I am with Ms. Jasmine Lee.
Hello po.
For all of you who probably haven't, you know, encountered her before, Ms. Jasmine Lee is basically, where do I even begin? So, she's my nina and a very good friend. And parang she's my sister here in Seoul. Seoul sister. But more than that, of course, she's an over-accomplished woman. Right now, she's a radio DJ.
You guys, if you love the series, you probably should get the book to have an idea of how it came to be. So, thank you very much, Hana, for coming today.
And but before that, for 4 years, she served in the assembly. In the South Korean assembly. Basically, she was a congresswoman. So there. I just wanted to, like, I know my channel is very small right now, but it's gonna grow big and gonna blow up. So look, for people who will get to re-watch this in the future, so you know, like, I'm in a very powerful woman beside me.
Just in case gusto nyo ano pala matuto ng Korean, you can learn Korean from me. I used to teach. I had a program, like, tatlong yes. programs teaching Korean using Tagalog. Nagtatagalog ako while I teach Korean.
Nang dumating ako sa Korea ay nakita ko ang larawan ng bulaklak na yuche sa Jeju-do, kaya talagang gusto ko makapunta doon. 한국에 오고 나서 제주도의 유채꽃 사진을 본 적이 있어요. 꼭 가보고 싶었어요.
That is how you learn. Really. Because my teacher in Korean is Filipina.
Ah!
Hindi Korean eh.
Okay.
Because I feel like if Korean will teach you how to speak Korean, I don't
See,
know.
Hindi na siya natuto sa asawa niya.
She speaks Korean beyond fluently. So anyway, actually, just an update lang naman. So what have you been up to these days after you finished your stint in the assembly?
I was in the assembly from 2012 to 2016.
Oh yeah.
So it was a four-year term. And then I went really low profile after that. Just was so crazy. Being the first member of Parliament of Korea, not born in Korea, came into the point it was met with opposition from people who really is against immigration or immigrants. Europe and the United States are traditionally immigrant countries, pero they're not really that friendly anymore. The same effect happened in Korea.
The trend changed.
Sometimes they were thinking that if big countries such as the US or Europe are trying to block immigrants from coming, why are we welcoming them, sort of? So it became so hard. Everything, it was so sensationalized, and everything that I do, really, everyone's looking at it through the microscope. So parang everything that you do will be magnified to levels that not all or many members of the parliament happens to experience.
Tama.
So you have to be careful. But if there's something that I regret the most after my stint at the assembly is the fact that I was a bit careful. I shouldn't have been careful. So I should have pushed more. I should have been
more out there.
Yeah, more out there. I should have pushed more with all of the things that I wanted to do. But I was careful because I was not sure of what the people are going to think of when it comes to, you know, me being too pushy or me being too
out there naman.
So I was trying to go down, but 4 years is really, you can think of it in a way na it's long, but basically it's just really a very short period of time. So after 4 years, that's the only regret I have. But I had to low profile because of the fact that I've been in the spotlight way too much than I expected, and it's not helping my kids too. They're being affected by everything. So I wanted to have a slow family life, so I got to concentrate on the things that I love the most, yung my civic works, those things that I did before I went to the parliament. And then now, 3 years now, this is actually my very first time. I'm really so worried and I'm really so nervous of the fact that I'm doing a radio show in English, which I'm not really sure I can do during the first few weeks. So, but this is actually the very first time that I'm going all out in the open again. A bear. Ano yun? That's winter. Anyway. Oh yeah, hibernating.
Okay. So, you've been in Korea since 1995.
Ilang anak ka na ba nun?
92 ako. Anyway, 1995, diba? For our viewers who are, you know, curious about what it was like for a foreigner that time living in Korea, how was it like for you?
Not much of foreigners around. The only people that they know of na foreigner will be Caucasian, mostly white or black.
Like the
they don't know brown.
The GIs.
Yeah, the GIs. Most of the kids back then in 1995 would look at me and realize I don't speak Korean, and then they would tell me, ah, Migugin. Migugin means American.
American, yeah.
And I was like, no, I'm not from America. I'm from a different country. And then they will tell me, you're not Korean. I'm not. Okay, Migugin. It was that rare to find like people from other. Yes, Awegugin.
So was there a from Korean language
no.
academy?
The only school we had was Yonsei University. They were asking for, I think, $2,500 for a 3-month...
$2,500 in a
language course, yes. For a 3-month language course. Because I think during that time, they're the only university offering the Korean language course.
So you guys have to be very grateful and thankful that you can easily learn Korean from anywhere, from the internet, diba?
So, and then nobody knows Korea. Way back.
Yes.
There were no Samsung, LG, Kia, Hyundai.
There
nobody
were no
knows.
K-pop no in 95.
Nobody knows.
HRT was 1995, 96.
During the time I was here. But, yeah, there were not a lot of foreigners around. So, I had to study Korean on my own.
How did you do that? How did you study Korean on your own? Because I couldn't study Korean on my own. And I'm married to one.
Before I came to Korea, I knew my husband for a year and a half. And the entire time we were dating, he will send me books. And way back then, cassette tapes pa siya. There's no CDs. I know how to read Korean before I came to Korea, though I did not have any idea what they meant. And then I live with all of my in-laws. So my mother-in-law, my father-in-law, my grandmother-in-law, and my brother-in-law. And no one speaks English.
Grandmother-in-law?
Yes. No one speaks English. What I have to do is study on my own. Mm. And my best teacher way back then is K-dramas. Without the subtitles.
Wow.
So I will just pick some words from the drama and then just
ask your husband.
Ask my husband, wow. What did that mean? What the best thing about living in Korea is, of course, you can practice
it.
But
yes.
If you cannot, if it's not available for you to talk to any Koreans, you just have to keep on saying it. And then the last thing that people learn is how to write in Korean. That's the most difficult part. I would think so. It's the other way around. Because for Koreans, they've been taught English for like 12 years. And they can write in English, but they cannot speak in English. If you live in Korea, you get to speak a lot of Korean words. You get to speak to a lot of people. So you can practice your speaking skills, but not your writing skills. During my time, we don't have all of those centers or free schools here in Korea. Now we have 218 multicultural centers.
Wow, 218.
Yes, where you can go to learn Korean for free. And there are a lot of NGOs who's offering Korean classes and a lot of schools offering free classes and a lot of groups offering like language exchange classes. There's a lot of it right now, but way back then, there's none of those. With writing, what I did was I find a newspaper, a news clip, a news article, a short news article, and I will just rewrite it. Back in those days, cell phones and text messaging isn't that...
They don't exist, yeah,
they,
maybe.
No, they exist, but it isn't as widely used.
1995? There was no text 95. So no text!
No text that time! No, but we have beepers. Beepers. We have beepers.
In Korea, the beepers were...
In numbers.
In
numbers.
Huh? What do you mean?
The first generation will be only numbers, so you can actually, yeah, you have to call that number. The person calls you. I mean, you call this phone number and the person will be waiting for your call. So the 8282 pali is like you write the number of the person, like the phone number 02123456 7, and then you will have 8282
emergency.
So that's emergency. You have to call right away. So they will just add it at the end. That's not a part of the phone number, but a part of. A part of, you know, to tell you to call right away. And most of the coffee shops in Korea way back then will have a phone in each of the table.
What?
Yes, they have a landline in each of the table. What? You did not even know that. Oh my god, I'm so old.
Yes, not even in the dramas, K-dramas, because remember how you just started. I mean, like at least in Southeast Asia, like 2001?
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that time, iba na yan. Like, that was like Winter Sonata level.
Yes.
And,
so no, that's way past the deeper
generation.
A lot of people will meet at coffee shops just because of the fact that they have landlines in all of the tables, in every table. Yes. So when you sit on a coffee shop, it's part of their services. You order coffee and you have a phone with you. So you just have to wait for the person that you text, you know, that you beeped to call you.
Can I just say, I'm freaking out right now because behind me, I don't know if I can show you in video because it's like, it's usually not allowed, but behind me are Crystal, Song Sung Hon, and my favorite, Ishii.
Ay, I'm 26, so I want to remember from 1993. 1993! 1 year old!